Yes, the fans are crying for the sickle.
And I think he's going to give it to him. Oh, no.
Watch it. This is what's going to happen. Nailing to the floor. The Russian sickle. The sickle. Oh, yes. Nikita Koloff.
Tony Schiavone, Jim Ross, and David Crockett ringside with World Championship Wrestling. Glad you could join us. Nikita Koloff. We saw him at the top of the two-hour program here today. Nikita Koloff, as Dusty Rhodes told us just a couple of weeks ago, coming back bigger, better, and stronger than ever before. The Jim Crockett Senior World Cup just around the corner for the superpowers, but also here tomorrow, 4 o'clock, the Clash of the Champions.
Tomorrow, we're on the eve of the Clash of Champions, and on the eve of the Clash of Champions here on TBS, many of the dignitaries in the world of professional wrestling, like the legendary promoter Paul Bostown, the NWA board of directors will be here. Peter Burkholz, the promoter in Houston, will be here. I understand Rob Garner, David of the Wrestling Network, here as well. A lot of big announcements about the Crockett Cup. And of course, we're all very excited about tomorrow.
That's right. Tomorrow you're going to find out the top 10 seeds in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Remember, that's 4 o'clock tomorrow. Clash of the Champions.
Eastern time, the Clash of the Champions. Also here with us today, Magnum T.A.
Right.
Also, it's always good to see Magnum T.A. back with us.
You're going to see Magnum T.A. Many of the teams that we're sure that you will see in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. We've got some very exclusive interviews with, like, the Four Horsemen and several men that will be involved in tomorrow night's event. Gentlemen, I think we've said it
Let's
all.
Go to the ring.
Let's go to the ring.
A Sheep Partner to Johnny Ace against Ryan Wagner and Tony Boba. And shall the Sheep Partners begin things? Certainly, Jim Ross, a team, as they go through their ceremonial salute to the New Zealand flag, certainly a team that has to be reckoned with. We made mention of the fact that there are teams in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup that have to be taken in regard to teams that will try to put you out of the sport, get you injured. Certainly the Sheep Herders went up.
You're exactly right, Tony. And another thing about the Sheep Herders, I think when we look at the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, we have to look at teams that have had a great deal of experience, not only just in tag team wrestling, but wrestling with a partner that they have entered the tournament with. And Luke Williams and Butch Miller can most definitely say that they have had a lot of experience wrestling with a partner. You see what I'm saying? The Sheepherders have been together for a long, long time.
Right.
I think that's going to help them in the tournament.
And don't forget, during the tournament, you have to get through Greenville on April 22nd. All 24 teams will be there wrestling. You got to get through that first night before you can go to Greensboro, and it's going to take a lot of stamina. And we know that they do have a lot of stamina, and we also know that they can take a lot of stamina out of you. So let's say the Sheepherders don't go through the first round, but the damage could be done on the team that keeps on going.
That's a very good point, Tony, and I think that they will advance past that first round, or survive might be a better word. If I was a wrestling fan, no matter where I was coming from, to come to this tournament, I would want to be there most certainly in Greenville, because that will be your only opportunity to see all 24 teams and also to see the Prince of Darkness death match with Kevin Sullivan and Jimmy Garvin, which could be one of the most physical and brutal matches of all time.
A stomp right to the back of the head. So, Butch Miller, one half of the Sheepherder. Johnny Ace on the outside takes Ryan Wagner, so to speak, coast to coast from one turnbuckle to the other. Stomping around now. Miller with them. Spring out of the ropes, right on the back of the head. So Miller knows all the pressure points, knows how to hurt somebody.
High impact maneuvers are the specialty of the Sheepherders. And I'll tell you something, Tony, not only do we have the officials like Rob Garner and Paul Bosch here representing the Wrestling Network and the NWA in this next 2 hours, we're also going to see a look at the Latin sensation Al Perez with his manager Gary Hart will be here, the Fantastics. Plus, a lot of controversy surrounding the big tag team championship matchup between Barry Windham and Lex Luger against Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. We'll show you a match involving that world championship where a lot of controversy surrounded it. We'll have that also in this first hour.
And Jim, you're right about that. Just a swirl of controversy surrounding that going into tomorrow's big event. when Luger and Windham will go after Tully and Iron for the World Tag Team belt. So that we'll talk about in depth, plus much more in this 2 hours of the nation's number one wrestling program, World Championship Wrestling, right here on Superstation TBS. A tag is made right back at the Sheepherder's corner. Now as Williams holds the man, here he comes. Butch Miller, he caught him right in the small of the back with the knee, or actually with the shin.
They're very good at taking advantage of the official's count. It's not a disqualification unless the official reaches a five count. So they will really milk the count, so to speak, and add the additional punishment as they are doing right here. You know, Tony, that I don't have a problem with them being patriotic for their country of New Zealand. I certainly don't, and I'm sure no one at the NWA has anything against New Zealand or the fine people there. I tell you what disturbs me, this whole situation involving these guys, is that young American carrying a New Zealand flag that has basically denounced his patriotism and his citizenship, so to speak, to the USA. To me, that's a little bit disturbing.
Yeah, I would agree with that 100%. Johnny Ace, who is from the USA, and not only that, you can talk well about your country without running down another.
Exactly.
And that's what the Sheepherders really do to the USA.
That's exactly right. I tell you, the Sheepherders, teams like the Sheepherders, the Lightning Express, the Jive Tones, the Black Horse, the Dark Horse teams, they are the ones that I think we really need to keep an eye out for. They're really going to be, I think, geared up to win $1 million at the Crockett Cup. High impact maneuver right off the second rope. We haven't seen them do too many wrestling holes, Tony. It's been basically, we're going to come right at your face. We're going to get in your face, and we're going to hammer you. And that's exactly what they have done thus far.
You have seen referee Teddy Long warn so many times over and over again about the throat. When he grabs his throat, it's a warning about the shot in the windpipe, which is so devastating, not only in the match itself, but to someone's career. You can really take someone out, put them in a hospital by just working on that neck. And that's what they've been doing.
They certainly have. This is a very physical team, a team that will not back up from anything. They want to prove that they are the superior tag team in the country. Rob Garner here from the Wrestling Network to talk about some additions, I know, to the tag team tournament we'll hear about a little bit later this first hour.
There they just enjoying themselves right now. You see Miller looking out of the fans, and the tag has been made to Luke Williams. They have really destroyed this team, certainly one of the premier teams going into the tournament. Over the top! Got a sunset flip and got a two count. Where he pulled that one out of, I'll never know, but that really just riled up Luke Williams even more.
That was a surprising move, and now the young man may pay for it in kind, as the Sheepherders now perhaps got a little bit lax there for a few seconds. But right to the head. They're very proud of the damage that they have done, no doubt about it. I'll tell you something, tomorrow night, in addition to that six-man matchup, Dusty Rhodes and the Road Warriors against the Powers of Pain inside the barbed wire, five other matches, and all of them for a championship.
And all of them with so much on the line because of a nationwide audience watching on Superstation TBS, coast to coast. And don't forget, it's 4 o'clock Eastern time tomorrow. So consult your local listen for the exact local time of your program. And there is a high knee that went right to the chin. They are really taking apart what they're doing right here. It's fairly obvious that they are showing the world every move that they have to prove to the opposition that they are ready. Well, what a mug.
That certainly is a face only a mother could love.
How would you like to stagger out into a dark alley one night and see that?
Boy, I could pass on that one. And his partner is no raving beauty also. Maybe a little raving sometimes, but he's certainly no beauty. They spent a lot of time on the sheep farm, those guys.
They really have. Right hand, back of the neck. And again, they're just bending that spine, working on it. And once again, now that you see the back of Johnny Ace there applauding his men on. Luke Williams shoved Wagner to the other side, and now, oh, he clipped him. He caught him right really in the teeth that time.
Big clothesline by Luke Williams, the lateral press, and only, well, he got a two count. I don't know. I think he could have probably ended that one just about the time they want to, the Sheepherders. Basically, as you said, Tony, it's Western Union here. This is a message for all the teams. The other teams will be in the tournament, all 24 teams. As we just said, we'll be participating and competing in Greenville on the 22nd. Flying knee right to the side of the head.
Yep, there's Teddy Long warning again into the throat, and they're going right to the some form of a chokehold or try to take out that windpipe, maybe cut the oxygen supply off to the brain, whatever. They're trying to hurt him. And they certainly have been very efficient about what the damage they've done here in this match.
You know, Tony, last week we had that big brawl here at the end of the program involving the Fantastics and the Midnight Express, and we're going to be seeing the Fantastics in live action here. Battering ram using the head of Luke Williams, just like a battering ram.
Yeah, you're right about the Fantastics, another great tag team, but take a look at this. Kind of a double
knee drop.
Yep.
Right to the, that's a move that they have really perfected. They've used it a lot of times. Double knee drop. The Sheep Herders gearing up for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. We're going to see it one more time. The Sheep Herders with a victory here on TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Watch the impact as they come down. A double knee drop. The Sheep Herders with the win. And ladies and gentlemen, the Twin Towers are standing by with David Crockett. Here's Barry Windham and Lex Luger.
All right, tomorrow at 4 o'clock, are they going to do it? Are they going to win the World Tag Team title, guys? What do you think?
That's right. Tomorrow at 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, the 27th, the World Tag Team Championships are up on the line. Tully Blanchard and Arn Anderson have finally decided to give us the title match that we wanted, and this is it. This is our chance to win the gold, the thing that we've been after, that we've been out here ranting and raving about for the last 3.5 months. Lex Luger and I are ready, and we're going to do it on the afternoon of the 27th.
All right, Lex.
You know, David, I can almost feel it. I can almost taste it. The excitement in the air. National TV, TBS, all the eyes, and the world of professional wrestling will be on us. The world tag team belts on the line. Barry and myself, Blanchard Anderson. It's time to put up or shut up. We've had a lot of support from these fans all across the country. I couldn't think of a better time to reward them. It's tomorrow night on TBS at 4 o'clock to become the new World Heavyweight Champions. And then, Barry Windham and myself are after the doubleheader, because in the Crockett Cup, there is $1 million. There are tag teams from all over the world, the very best in wrestling. Me and Barry are going to enter there as the World Tag Team Champions. And it wouldn't be a better thing to walk away with as the new Crockett Cup Champions as well. The month of April could be a very big month for the tag team of Windham and Luger. Because it just doesn't get.
What can I say?
Are you better than this, baby? Yeah, Windham and Luger, we're going for it all, baby.
All right, the whole world is watching the Superstation TBS and the NWA. More action to come right after this.
Okay, fans, back on the Superstation. Happy to have Mr. Rob Garner, member of the NWA Board of Governors, the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament. Rob, right around the corner, and I know you have some big announcements for us.
Tony, the 24-team field has just been completed with the additional signings of tag teams from Japan and Mexico. Also, on April 22nd in Greenville, South Carolina that night, besides seeing all 24 teams, there's a special Prince of Darkness match with Kevin Sullivan against gorgeous Jimmy Garvin.
Okay.
Now, the next night in Greensboro, North Carolina, of course, are the finals
right.
of the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, and the world champion will be defending his title.
Can you feel her breathing down your neck, Robert?
Absolutely.
I guarantee you they won't like us in Dallas, but when the show's over tonight, you and I, and this beautiful young lady, Patty Mullen, the pet of the year, she's got girlfriends all over the world, and we're gonna take Greensboro apart tomorrow night. You understand what I'm talking about? Tomorrow night, after Ric Flair successfully defends the World Heavyweight Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, as ludicrous as it might be, they have set this up to have three judges. That's right, three judges outside the ring, just in case Sting is fortunate enough to wrestle me the entire 60-minute time limit. So what do? You know me to be a man way beyond his means in every department. I says to myself, What kind of a judge do I know beyond a shadow of a doubt will rule in favor of the Nature Boy? So, I look around the country, and who's available? The most beautiful woman on the face of this earth, the pet of the year, Patty Mullen, flies right in, woo, in the Learjet, in the Greensboro. She's gonna be styling. Oh, Tony, get close to this baby. And profiling is only she can do. And I want everybody in Greensboro, I'm talking about all you punks that think you've been somewhere with a woman and never have been, to look at what the Nature Boy is standing next to. How about this? Tony, talk to her, brother. She's not only good looking, she can talk all night long.
It must be quite a thrill being right here with the world champion and being part of the big event tomorrow.
Oh, it is. I'm looking so forward to it.
Oh, God.
Oh, you can't beat that, can you?
Sting, Sting, you know how I like to show off. I'm the kind of guy that likes to tell you how it is. And when I've got something, woo, like Patty Mullen standing 10 feet from me, you know for a fact, Luger, you got to be beside yourself. You and that punk Barry Windham out here, when she saw you pop that shirt, Luger, 5 minutes ago, she said, Nature Boy, Luger's a lot like that punk Sting. They think that running around doing this does it for women like myself. It doesn't, guys. They like clothes. They like airplanes. They like limousines. They like men of the world. Oh, baby. Tomorrow, Greensboro, woo! The Nature Boy will ride high in the skies. Tony, you be there. She got a friend for you too, pal.
That's good to know. Let's go to the ring. Oh, there's only one Ric Flair. Wouldn't you agree with that?
Yes, sir. Boy, you're gonna have a good time, Tony. It sounds like there at Greensboro.
Al Perez going up against Alan Martin in this event. Notice how I didn't even acknowledge that.
I don't blame you. Al Perez, the Latin heartthrob of Gary Hart, Nice Fireman Carry Takeover. Al Perez is as Gary Hart had, and there he is. Certainly no stranger to wrestling fans, wherever they're watching this program. Hart says that Perez is his best find of all time. And the fans have been following wrestling a long time, Tony. Can think back on the years of all the wrestlers that Gary Hart has had in his managerial stable, so to speak. And it really reads like a who's who in wrestling. He says this young man is his best yet.
And there's reasons behind that. He points to youth, for one thing, that this man, Al Perez, has a lot of years left in the sport, development. But also what he points to in Al Perez is his ability to learn and to adapt in pressure situations. He's one of those men like a Shane Douglas and a Ricky Sandown who's come a long way in a short period of time.
He certainly has. And I think he has really progressed to the point to where he is no doubt a bona fide contender for the United States Heavyweight Championship, now held by the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. You know, Ric Flair has got great taste in clothes and cars, jewelry, and, of course, women, which is quite obvious. The Stinger's got a judge, too.
Yeah, he really does.
And his judge played a lot of pro football, and is a guy that is certainly fans are going to know. Big Lyle Alzado will be at ringside in Greensboro tomorrow and will be Sting's judge. And I think that Sting has got a real—he's got a man that knows a lot about athletics. Plus, the NWA will appoint a third judge also for tomorrow afternoon's big event.
It'll be very interesting that judge's situation, Jim, because Lyle Alzado, as great a football player as he was, I know being a judge in professional wrestling as well as Patty Mullen's going to be something different for them.
Exactly right, and I tell you, Al Perez—that was a great move—a modified airplane spin. And a big knee drop right to the solar plexus. This young man is in great condition. He's very intense. He makes very few mistakes. Nice move. Pinning predicament on Alan Martin. But Al Perez is a man that Gary Hart's very, very high on. And I want to tell you, he's got all the qualifications, Tony. Another great, that was a single leg takedown and a modified version of such.
Perez looking out at the fans now. He drags Martin about a quarter of the way across, and that is a very vulnerable position to
to be in right there, regardless of who you are, who's standing over top of you. Martin, really no place to go at all. Perez actually just pulling right on the groin muscle and now snaps right down on that right leg.
You know, Tony, growing up in Oklahoma and now living in Plano, Texas, I've had the opportunity to be around a legendary gentleman by the name of Paul Bosch, who will be joining us in our next segment here on TBS. And I know you got to meet him before we went on the air today. He's quite a legend. He's a man that was doing what we do before we ever even thought about it. In the 1930s and 40s, he was doing radio play-by-play for wrestling.
And that says a lot right there. You're talking about a creative person and one great person to be around. Paul Bosch will be with us right after the break. Now, Perez just really knocked his socks off to Rabbit Old Cliche around, and now the spinning toe hold really has it cinched there.
Remember the Funk Brothers from West Texas, Terry and Dory Funk Jr., both former NWA World Champions, and that's the hole that took them to the championship. The spinning leg lock, Al Perez has mastered it. I think Gary Hart is right. He does have an extraordinary athlete in his camp, and we'll take another look at the Latin sensation, Al Perez.
But just like the Funk Brothers, there it takes a very vivid mean streak in you. And he's got one. Al Perez, we're going to take a look right now. He leveled him right there. There was no doubt about it. Could have pinned him, but here's his move, the spinning toe. One more time.
Al Perez has got a tremendously strong athlete in great condition. He really locks in the spinning leg lock. And Al Perez is a winner here on the Superstation. And we'll be back with Paul Bosch as he joins Tony Schiavone, plus the Fantastics and much more right after this time.
Okay, fans, we're back, and we're very, very honored and very pleased to have Mr. Paul Bosch, member of the NWA Board of Governors, with us. Peter Burkholz is with us. And Mr. Bosch, great to have you out here. Houston, Texas, one of the hottest spots, probably the hottest place for professional wrestling in the world, especially the NWA.
Well, I think that the NWA finds good fans wherever they appear, because they go back to the basics of wrestling and they go beyond that to a point that pleases people. And I've been connected with the NWA since about 1947 when it was first formed. And I find that right now is a good time for the NWA as it was then. And Peter Burkholz here is here to represent Houston wrestling. I'm here because I'm visiting with the NWA.
And Peter, they say the hottest place to be on a Friday night is the Sam Houston Coliseum, and I know that May 13th, another big event comes to the Sam Houston Coliseum.
That's correct, Tony. The tradition's back in Houston, Texas. Friday, May 13th, Sam Houston Coliseum, the NWA, another tremendous card. Maybe one of the biggest cards in Houston wrestling history. The World's Heavyweight Champion has signed, and every day, Tony, more stars in NWA are making their commitment. Friday, May 13th, Houston, Texas, we're excited about it.
And I know the NWA is very excited about it too, Mr. Bosch. I tell you what, the Fantastics are coming out, and it's an honor for me to be out here with you, because not only in promotions, but as an announcer.
I was going to say that about you.
Well, I appreciate that. Please stay with me, because I can't pass up the chance of having you at the microphone
with
me.
I'd appreciate it.
For this next match.
Thank
okay.
You.
Paul Bosch will be with us. Let's go to the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the City of the Angels, please welcome Tommy Rogers and Bobby Fulton, the Fantastics.
Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton, the Fantastics, and that scene right there, Mr. Bosch, going around the ring, acknowledging the fans. It's so good to see that in this sport.
Well, it's good for me to see it, because it shows that they have a feeling for the fans. But I've known this team for several years, and they are remarkable athletes. The gentleman in the ring there with the long blonde hair was started by Bull Curry, one of the ruggedest veterans of the mat. It is the late Bull Curry now, but he trained these two boys, and they do well.
They're quite a tag team. Bobby Fulton in the ring and Tommy Rogers outside. Certainly a lot of excitement. And it was just last week on this program where, and I know you know Jim Cornette and you've known him for a couple of years. I've never seen Jim Cornette lose his cool before and throw things like he did at these two men.
Well, I think he recognizes in the teamwork that these boys are able to produce that his team is in serious trouble. And Cornette can't stand that. He's the kind of a guy who rides high when things are going his way. But when things start to look tough, Cornette fades.
I think you're exactly right. A high backdrop of Tommy Rogers landed the right way and a drop kick on Gene Ligon. And right to an arm drag right up with an arm bar. So Tommy Rogers, Bobby Fulton, still with the pressure on. Now, the Fantastics, the Midnight Express, will match up tomorrow on the Clash of Champions for the U.S. Tag Team title. And for the Fantastics to come in only a couple of weeks and get a shot at the title says a lot about it.
Well, I would tell you this, that if you were asking me to pick the winner, I'd say the Fantastics. I think they have a tremendous chance based on ability. That's the point. Not on their record here with the fans in this part of the country, but on their ability and the things they have done every place they've appeared.
All right, great teamwork right there. So there we get a prediction from Mr. Paul Bosch, and I know that Jim Cornette's listening along, and we'll have a few words about that. But they have taken him to the limit. They have defeated the Midnight Express on Nationwide TV, so they got the advantage mentally on it.
Yes, they got a big jump on Jim Cornette, too.
That's
when
right.
You can leave him speechless, you've pronounced a major miracle.
That's right. Tommy Rogers holding right on now to Atkinson. And Rogers, we talk about the quickness. There's a lot of power in that little man right there also.
He makes up for any weight that he doesn't have by his quickness. And pound for pound, he is as tough as any man I have seen. Any man. And he demonstrates that when he gets in against men who outweigh him and then whips them.
You know, you've seen so many great tag teams through the years, and I know you would agree with me. As we lead into the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, in the NWA, the tag team scene right now is at its peak right now.
Well, I have been with the tag team, Crockett tag team tournaments, and have seen them, and I think that this is the greatest action that you can compile in any one ring anywhere.
That'll be April 22nd and 23rd, Greenville, South Carolina. And fans, don't forget, all 24 teams will be in competition. A little bit different in a tournament atmosphere because basically on a regular night you'll wrestle one time, but in a tournament you can wrestle four or five times in the span of two nights.
Well, you've got to be in shape. You've got to be ready for it. You've got to be young. You've got to be able to absorb punishment and come back. In a match like this, you know that you're going to go to bed and try to sleep some of it off.
Right.
But you don't do that in a tournament. You sit around and wait and sweat, get a little chill once in a while, and you know that you're going to go in there with a team that has also won its match.
That's right.
And this, of course, increases the tension and doubles the enjoyment to the fans. I think that being there and seeing what's happening and participating in it with your own voice and your own opinions, that's being a number one fan.
Okay, I would agree with every word of that. And right now, Bobby Fulton and Tommy Rogers really exciting the fans to know. And as Tommy comes all the way across, right down on the arm. Quickness, great teamwork. They've been working together a long time, and it really shows right here in the ring.
It does. They seem to follow each other's thoughts rather than what's going on in the ring. They anticipate the touch, and they're ready for it. And they don't waste any touches. They get the strength in there quickly when they need it.
Head scissors, Teddy Long checking in. He got a one count in. Bobby Fulton dropped down. He's down there with the fans, and the fans are just eating. There he is, right down there sitting at ringside with the fans. And they're all right with the Fantastics.
They haven't changed since the last time I saw them about 6 months ago. They are still as great as they were. They are fantastic.
They really are. They really, really fit the meaning of that term. Bobby Fulton in against Gene Ligon. They have really worked him over. But Gene caught him. Right when Bobby Fulton thought he had it going his way, he really nailed him.
That's right. And he gave him a legal blow in using that forearm. And the forearm can deliver a tremendous pressure without worrying about breaking a bone in your hand. That's why forearm blows are tougher to take sometimes than fists.
High backdrop. And Bobby Fulton going right after Gene Ligon one more time. The Fantastics Ligon with a sweeping side headlock that time, and now back to the corner. A tag, has it been made? Yes, it has. To Rogers, leapfrog over the top, and now double backdrop. Boy, this is great teamwork at its best right now.
You can't get teamwork better than that. It comes from experience as well as coming from the fact that they have worked this between themselves in advance with the Fantastics. And as Bobby goes out of the ring, he knows that Tommy can take over and hang right on and soften it up for the ultimate finish, they hope.
Great confidence in the partner. There's no doubt about that. A tag has been made as he raked the man in the eyes. And Al Fulton for a minute on the defensive, but now he resounds with a hard right hand. A tag has been made.
There was a tag. that. And here comes Tommy, and he throws him over, and he lands on top, and there is a fall. There was an expedient measure. You have to take chances if you're going to win. They took a chance. They won.
Very well put, Mr. Bosch. They took a chance, and they won. And Jim Ross making his way over to the ringside. He'll be talking to the Fantastics, and this was just a great tag team match. And that was right from the Midnight Express playbook right there, the rocket launcher.
Right, they're showing that they can do it better.
Let's go to Jim Ross. He's talking with the Fantastics.
Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock Eastern Time in Greensboro, North Carolina, the Fantastics will get the opportunity that they have long waited for, and that's for the United States Tag Team Championship. Gentlemen, tomorrow afternoon, 4 o'clock, it's you all, the Midnight Express. It's going to be quiet an evening.
I'll tell you what now, I want to thank all these people out here for their support. It's music to our ears. And tomorrow in the comfort of your own living room, or you can come down to the matches right there in Greensboro. Jimmy Cornette, we understand that your mother has went and bought a ringside ticket. Now, none of us has ever seen her, so that's going to be a sight for sore eyes. But let me tell you something, Jimmy. Polish those belts up, because tomorrow in Greensboro, the Clash of the Champions, something the Fantastics want. Real, real bad. And like we said, we're not stealing your moves. We're going to show you that we're just that much better. This is music to our ears, Mr. Ross. We want to say a special hello, and we love you and support us right here at 4 o'clock on TBS.
That rocket launcher that I saw was dynamic, and I'll tell you something, it was awesome.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Ross. Just like Bobby said, just that much better makes all the difference. But it's less than 24 hours right now, Mr. Ross, and the butterflies are mounting. Bobby and myself, we're fired up, but we know when we get in that ring, the butterflies are going to dissipate. And Bobby Eaton, Stan Lane, you're going to be ours right there in Greensboro. And just like Bobby said earlier, with all these people's support, we can't go wrong in Greensboro. And Bobby and myself are just fired up, and we're glad we're right in that ring, especially with a title shot.
You know, I want to say one more thing, Jimmy Cornette. Tomorrow in Greensboro, we're going to beat the Midnight Express. Cornette, there's not a thing you can do about it. Let's fire it up, folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with a special look at the World Tag Team Championship right after this very brief timeout.
Thank you, Jim.
There's a team that's been chasing the World Tag Team Champions, Barry Windham and Lex Luger. Now, they had a match with Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, the World Tag Team Champions recently. Magnum TA commentator ringside, a very controversial ending because, as you know, those World Tag Team belts are the utmost in our sport.
Well, did you ever know Blanchard, for instance, or any of these fellows who are connected with him who do not have the streak to be able to excite controversy? They never do things the way they should. Right. They do things according to their own rules, and no team should exist that doesn't pay attention to rules that are valid and certainly that are examined and then are given to the wrestlers to obey.
Well, and there's one man that feels the same way. His name is Magnum T.A. Now, we'll be talking to him a little bit later about what had happened. I want you to see for yourself now the ending of the match. Magnum T.A., commentator at ringside. Then the action really broke loose. Let's take a look at it.
This is what it's all about. It can all happen right here. Barry Windham can take him out. Barry with a big scoop power slam.
Count up two with a lateral press. A great scoop power slam by Barry Windham. And now Windham goes to the ropes. Big forearm. Wait a minute. Magnum T.A. is getting up. There's J.J. Dillon here at ringside. Magnum's got that baseball bat. Magnum said this match was too important to have outside interference. There's a roll-up, a pinning predicament here, but Anderson with a big right hand, but Luger's in the ring. Anderson and Luger outside.
Sixer on the other side. Windham over the top. Can he get him over? Can he get him over? Maiden just hit J.J. Dillon. Maiden just hit J.J. Dillon. And the bat, the baseball bat. The baseball bat just hit Tully Blanchard. We had a two count. The commission referee is here. The baseball bat, whether it be inadvertent or not, hit Tully Blanchard. The commission referee has stopped it due to Magnum T.A. using that baseball bat, whether it be accidentally or not. He used the baseball bat on Tully Blanchard. The horseman now, it's a...
And here he is, truly the boss, Magnum T.A. Welcome, really.
Well, thank you, David. You know, maybe it's time that I clear a few things up here. There's been a few discrepancies going on. People say a little controversy. Well, I say there's a whole lot of controversy because, you see, it wasn't so long ago that I came out here and tried to lend my expertise, maybe do a little commentating here on TBS. And everybody took that opportunity to take their pot shots at me. So I had to move into a new adversity in life, maybe. I had to pick up a little bit of an equalizer, namely this baseball bat. Well, you know, that doesn't make me feel good because I don't like having to have an equalizer, but I make no mince words about the fact that I'm not 100% yet. I'm not ready to climb back in the ring, but that day will come. So Tully Blanchard, Arn Anderson, I don't apologize for getting involved in a situation where it should have just been four men involved, but again and again, James Day Dillon has to put his two cents worth in. Well, I just merely put in my two cents worth, and then Tully Blanchard wanted the bat. Well, he wanted the bat, I gave him the bat, and it felt real good doing it. Because you see, I'm no commentator. I'm no fancy Dan guy to dress up. The warrior still lives inside me.
You know, Magnum, you and I go back a long, long way. You know, I know that they're selling videos of you and I in an I Quit match, and you love it. You're getting money off of me because something that didn't happen. I've had to live for 2 years with I Quit. I quit everywhere I go. I quit because of you. But you know, Magnum, I felt sorry for you. Poor Magnum, like everybody else. He got hurt, poor ended his career. Well, that's too bad. But you know, Magnum, when you start sticking your nose back in our business again, you stay out until you can crawl back in the ring. Then you start sticking your ring in. I don't care about equalizers. You want to bat.
Fire enough. You just want to. Oh.
Oh, my God.
Well, as we watch the Varsity Club go up against Stallion and Tommy Angel, there's no doubt we have witnessed right before our eyes, right at our feet, Jim Ross, one of the most shocking developments ever. And we've been doing this show 3 years now. I've never seen anything like what happened, not only to Magnum T.A., but to Mr. Jim Crockett. It,
it's beyond description, really, right now.
I was talking to Paul Bosch a few moments ago. He's been in this sport for 55 years, and he said he had never seen anything like what has just transpired here. Magnum T.A. suffered a laceration. Magnum's going to be all right. He's tough. There's no doubt. He's a warrior. He's a tough man. He's going to be okay. Jim Crockett, we know he's being attended to, so we'll obviously try to keep you abreast of that situation. And
now, David is usually here with us doing the interviews. David has gone with his brother, Jim Crockett, at this time. We hope to get a report from David a little bit later on. But what we saw, ladies and gentlemen, was a very serious incident that occurred right here on the Superstation as Steiner unloads right on the Stallion. And this varsity club, as mean and as rugged as they are, taking care of the Stallion right here.
Well, these guys are certainly going to be one of the prime forces in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup Tag Team Tournament. They'll be one of 24 teams that will try to survive through the opening rounds in Greenville, South Carolina, Friday night, April 22nd. There you see the Games Master, Kevin Sullivan. And there's just no telling what kind of evil thoughts lurk in the mind of that man. But one thing is for certain, Tony, he has put together a team that if they walked away with $1 million for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, I would not be totally surprised. They have that kind of ability.
I tell you what, we saw Sullivan shaking his head right there. And, you know, all of our wrestlers back in their odd number of dressing rooms that they have and different parts of the building can see the monitor and saw what happened. And as evil as Kevin Sullivan in, that shake of his head, I just feel that he was referring to what we have seen. Because we saw a man, Dusty Rhodes, with that baseball bat hit anything and everything that moved, it almost seemed. Mr. Crockett came in, and then he was unloaded on by the force of that bat. That is still on the mind of all of us right now, and hopefully we can update you on that situation during the remainder of this program, a little bit over an hour to go.
As a matter of fact, fans, we will be showing you, I've been notified, a videotape of the incident that we're talking about. So if you just joined us, I'm sure you're going to be as shocked as we all are, and I'm anxious to see it again because it happened so fast that we'll be taking another look at it before we go off the air today.
We were all, at least you had to be at home because I was stunned and just absolutely appalled by Tully hitting Magnum, and then when Mr. Crockett went down, well, I really didn't know what even to think.
Kevin Sullivan kicking away at the helpless Tommy Angel here, and Rick Steiner just ran Tommy Angel's head into the television camera, which is not only not very smart, but it's also very, very dangerous. Why these guys can't, the varsity club can't stay in the ring, they don't need coat hangers, they don't need 3-on-1, they have a great God-given wrestling ability, why don't they use it? And I don't want me to get on a soapbox, but why don't they use their natural ability? And not listen to Kevin Sullivan. What a clothesline. In anybody's league, Tony, anybody's book, that was a devastating clothesline.
And that's a natural move. That is an awesome professional wrestling move, that clothesline. And that throwing the man out on the floor was not. Now here comes the Syracuse athlete, Mike Rotunda, the world television champion. Together, the varsity club, Barry Austin. Now, let's don't forget, fans, everybody's thinking about tomorrow at 4 o'clock at the Clash of the Champions. Now, you got to wonder what has transpired, how much of an effect that'll have on what we'll see in the next couple of weeks here in the NWA.
Well, one thing about tomorrow, the fans are going to find out at the same time we will, because if they're sitting at home and watching TBS, which we hope they are, they're going to be seeing it as we see it, as it happens live. And we hope the fans in the Greensboro area, Raleigh, Winston-Salem, the whole area there, look forward to seeing them tomorrow afternoon. Tony, as you said, this is a great team, but gosh, it's hard to keep your train of thought on what we're seeing because my mind wants to go back to what we have seen, and that's very, very distasteful. This was the repercussions from that event were going to be heard for a long time. What a perfect power slam. What a perfect power slam. Steiner, instead of going for a pin or going for another wrestling hold, here's the bully that's going to put somebody around.
Both men now holding up the man, hitting him up against the ropes. Tommy Angel just dangling right like a rag doll up against the ropes. Double team here. Both members of the varsity club with the double clothesline. The Garrett and the Stallion irate. Everybody's on edge here. goes Tommy Angel right to the floor. Sullivan, he's not beneath him to kick him in the head. And that's exactly what he does.
And he's not wearing wrestling boots. He's wearing cowboy boots with leather soles and some kind of steel tips on them, on the toes of the boots. He doesn't care. He's sadistic, evil. He's a bad man.
That's aptly put, a bad man.
He probably enjoyed what we just saw, as sick as he is.
Now it'll stretch now by Rotunda with that grimace on his face. As you can see, the Tommy Angels in a lot of pain. If you just joined us, we witnessed right before our very eyes one of the most incredible sights, startling, appalling sights ever. And hopefully, as you said, Jim Ross, we'll get to show to our fans a little bit later on.
Belly-to-back suplex. Steiner just planted Tommy Angel. And this varsity club, they're gearing up to go for $1 million. They're going to hurt a lot of people along the way. And don't forget that Kevin Sullivan has the Prince of Darkness death match with gorgeous Jimmy Garvin in Greenville on Friday night, April the 22nd. We're going to be talking to Kevin Sullivan and the varsity club. But, Tony, we're going to take another look at the closing moments of this tag team event.
All right, here it is one more time. Your winners, the Varsity Club. We'll talk to them after we take this very short break.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, they're gearing up for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup.
Let's talk about something else. Yeah. He finally snapped. You see, I knew it was coming. The pressure defending the U.S. belt, the Varsity Club coming on strong. Gary Hart has risen from the bogs, has come back. You know, the pressure on Dusty Rhodes has been insurmountable the last few months. You can see he was carrying the weight of the world on his shoulders. I knew he was going to snap, but I didn't think the dark side of him would take over. He is mad now. He is absolutely mad. He's fallen to the abyss of the loss. You see, if that incident happened when he took the bat and tried to beat the life out of Tully Blanchard.
Provoked
or not, he didn't try to just whack Tully Blanchard. He tried to take the life out of Tully Blanchard. He was looking not at ending Tully Blanchard's career, but ending his very existence on this planet. You see, if this had happened someplace else, he would have been locked up for 90 days because they would have tested him to see if he was criminally insane. What we just witnessed was an act of a madman, an act of a terrorist, and in all my days, you call me evil, you call me demented, and you call me sick. What I saw, I liked. I saw something from a sick, evil man that has finally taken that step. He may have been the American dream at one time. He might have been the man that stood for righteousness. But what I just witnessed, I witnessed a madman on the loose. And if something isn't done, nobody's safe. You see, we will take it to the limit. But he took a bat, and he was trying to bash Tully Blanchard's brains out. Do you understand, Jim Ross? If I was a lawyer, I'd have a dead, solid case against him. Tully, if I was you, call somebody. My man, that was an act of a criminally insane individual.
It was an act of a man that was provoked, and Tully Blanchard had no business attacking Magnum T.A. I don't agree with Sullivan's comments whatsoever. Ron Simmons is in the ring. Let's go there now, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Jim Ross. Ron Simmons against David Diamond in this event. On our two-hour edition of World Championship Wrestling with your second hour here, we have still many of the stars of the NWA remaining. We'll talk about the big clash of the champions tomorrow. And like we said, we are going to take a look once again at an incident that's on everybody's mind. And you said it at home right now. We know it's on yours. And it happened so quick. It's like an accident. It happens so quick sometimes that it goes by and you're stunned. And we were for many minutes here. I know Mr. Crockett was attended to. David has left with his brother. Hopefully, we'll be talking to David a little bit later on about the incident we saw. It was Dusty out here with a baseball bat, and I agree with what you said about Kevin Sullivan's remarks.
Oh, he acts now like, you know, Dusty really should be reprimanded, as if Sullivan wouldn't have done. Sullivan does that stuff as a normal course of the day. Dusty Rhodes was provoked into that frenzy. He was provoked to do what he did. Anyway, Ron Simmons doesn't take a lot of provocation to get him fired up. He's a former four-time football All-American from Florida State, and he is hammering David Diamond here on TBS. And this young man, I really believe that Ron Simmons has an opportunity to ascend to the highest level in professional wrestling, and that's the heavyweight championship of the world. That's what Sting wants from Nature Boy Ric Flair. Sting gets his chance tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock Eastern time here on TBS. Ron Simmons' time, Tony, is coming down the line, and I think he's got all the physical tools it takes to get him there.
And to be able to be recognized for the shot, you have to prove yourself on nationwide TV in the many arenas around the country. And certainly Ron Simmons, from the reports we hear from the promoters all around the country, and from what we're seeing right here on Nationwide TV, Jim Ross is doing just that, proving himself and going after the big one. Right now, just working right on David Diamond. Teddy Long checking in. World Championship Wrestling all over the world. Great to have you with us, and I know it's been a day we'll never forget. There is Mark Clayton, wide receiver of the Miami Dolphins, who's enjoying the action with us. Fine wide receiver, teaming up with Dan Marino and watching another great former football player. And that man right there, Ron Simmons.
Simmons with a Boston Crab. Simmons is so strong, he's in tremendous condition. And we're going to see another one of the young great ones here in the NWA. Sting will be coming along with us in the second hour. Plus, we're going to be talking with J.J. Dillon, who had a very close personal look at what all transpired. I'm anxious to hear his comments. And plus, we're going to see the Midnight Express. And we'll also see, courtesy of videotape, the incident that Tony and I were talking about, and hopefully have a progress report about Jim Crockett from his brother David.
And you won't want to miss the videotape replay. It actually made the hairs on the back of your neck stand up. It was just a hair-raising event that we're going to take a look at. Ron Simmons, that knee is not necessarily supposed to stay in that position for any length of time.
You're right. Not very comfortably, anyway.
Not at all.
Simmons is just, I tell you, all he needs is seasoning. He just needs some time. He's got every physical tool it takes to go as far as his attitude and the breaks taking. He's going to have a few breaks. It's like tomorrow night. An individual or a team that gets a break tomorrow night can walk away with a championship, because we've got five titles on the line tomorrow afternoon here on the Class of the Champions.
Attitude is a good word, because so we've seen, and I know you have, Jim, in your years in wrestling, seen a guy with this makeup, this talent, this structure, and this ability with no attitude at all. And yep, it all goes right down the drain.
But then you see some that are blessed with a lot of God-given talent, like a Nikita Koloff or a Steve Dr. Death Williams, both men on their way back to the NWA, who have that great attitude to couple with their athletic ability. Simmons up with a bear hug, and he's one of the few guys that can beat you with quickness moves or with a big power moves like we're seeing right here. Man, I'll tell you, he is strong.
Simmons now hooking the leg and the arm of David Diamond and just pulling back on it. As you can see, Diamond, the only thing he can do is try to shut out the paint at this time.
He was the most dominant defensive lineman in the Southeast Conference in the 1980s. And this young man, I'll tell you something. You know, we've talked about how high he finished in the Heisman Trophy balloting. He has got the great, great ability. We look for tremendous things from him.
Pulling down both legs now. Once again in the Boston Crab, he pulls right on David Diamond. Ron Simmons, World Championship Wrestling fans, and Simmons has literally torn this man apart, showing us all he has. His power moves, his quickness moves, his power slams, he's done it all.
Big Ron Simmons, a man that dominated college football when he played. He feels like that he has the opportunity, when the time comes, to also dominate his chosen sport of professional wrestling. And I'm not going to argue with a big man, I'll tell you that right now. I'm not going to debate him. He's got a great attitude. Very intelligent. He got a college degree, which is, I think, just tremendous. He's a great role model for a lot of young athletes, is Ron Simmons.
Pulling on him now.
still cannot get over. And Magnum walk, well. I keep thinking David's going to come out here and tell us how Jim Crockett Jr. is. I saw Magnum. He's going to be okay. Magnum's, he's tough.
Shocking enough, really.
But Jim Crockett got hit with a baseball bat.
Yeah.
And that's darn serious.
And right in the throat.
Tully Blanchard. Ron Simmons come up the second rope. Tully Blanchard is, they're still tending to him. And Ron Simmons.
You know, we had just talked earlier about the sheepherders hitting the throat and pounding on the throat and how much of a vulnerable part that was of the body. And then we see it stretch across a man's throat, the baseball bat, and hit Mr. Crockett near the throat. We take a look at Ron Simmons. And, buddy, he got some elevation this time, really springing off of the turnbuckle right there.
Ron Simmons, the big man from Florida State, the Seminole with four All-American citations to his credit, has just racked up another victory here on the Superstation. And, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back in just a few moments with Sting on TBS.
Sting going up against Max MacGyver in this event. You know, we mentioned that Lyle Alzado will be in ringside and the judge, one of the judges in tomorrow's big event. And certainly it has to be the biggest moment in the career of this young man tomorrow, the Superstation.
You're exactly right. Of course, Ric Flair's judge, a lot prettier than Lyle Alzado. I don't know if she knows anything about wrestling, but Patty Mullen, 1988 Pet of the Year, will be at ringside in Greensboro tomorrow afternoon.
Fans, if you just joined us, we were witness to an appalling scene out here right before our eyes, right at ringside, involving Magnum T.A., Tully Blanchard, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Mr. Jim Crockett. It was not a pretty thing to see. It was really just violent, and we're going to take another look at it. We understand. Also talk to James J. Dillon. It's something that you can see that has affected everybody out here today.
I think it's affected Magnum T.A.'s aggressiveness also, Tony, as you said. Just a little less than 24 hours away, this young man from California will have the opportunity on a national television broadcast to walk away with the biggest prize in all of professional wrestling, the NWA World's Heavyweight Championship.
To say that we are shocked and we are stunned at this moment would be an understatement. Still, we have much more of this program to go. Talk to you about the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. And also the fact that this man Sting, as you said, Jim Ross, in less than 24 hours will step into the ring. James J. Dillon locked in that cage. And Sting will have his chance against the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. All right, here we go. Over through the middle. And then that flying maneuver by Sting, which always precedes the Scorpion Deathlock. Legs crossed. And the power put on. Bending the man back. Who's handed up Max MacGyver. And Sting will pick up the win. Jim is going to go to the ring to talk to Stinger right now. As we take a look one more time at the man flying across, and then a look at the Scorpion Deathlock. Here we go. Sting gets his start from the opposite neutral cutter. Look at that lift. Oh, he really got way up in the air. Out of the force down across the upper part of the body. And then as the man drops down, the Scorpion Deathlock was hooked on. Here it is. Max MacGyver prone at this time. The leg in, crossed over. Your winner with the Scorpion Deathlock is Sting. Jim Ross is up in the ring with the Sting.
Great victory for you, less than 24 hours away from the biggest match of your life in Greensboro. I said it's a great victory for you, Sting.
I heard you. I got to reach farther than I've ever had to reach for all any kind of composure that I have left. After what I saw, my friends, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Magnum T.A., tomorrow night, one of the most important matches of my life. I can't get my train of thought. Most important match of my life tomorrow, and I got to get it together, and I can't believe what happened out here. I don't even want to do this interview. I don't feel like talking. That's all I have to say.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that shows you the kind of athlete he is. The biggest match of his career less than 24 hours away. He's thinking about his friends, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Magnum TA. We'll be right back and speak with J.J. Dillon after this timeout.
Very disturbing day for many of us here. And Mr. James J. Dillon, leader of the Four Horsemen, the only thing we have to say is really what's on your mind right now.
Well, first thing on my mind is I'm out here at this moment not to say anything cute, not to come out here to entertain you. I'm not out here to brag about the Four Horsemen. I'm out here to address a situation that took place not 10 feet from me earlier today. Now, Magnum TA, number one, first, we saw your interference in a match, Cincinnati, Ohio, where the world tag team titles were at stake. And even though the fans here today maybe didn't see the total story, following the match, the Horsemen put it on record that we would not tolerate any such incidents again. You were out there under the guise of a commentator sitting at the desk with a microphone in front of your hand. Now, I realize, because I've been in competition myself, that you as a champion had a fire inside of you that only champions have. And even though you were in a horrible wreck, that fire, that flame inside of you was never stuffed out. Now, you've had to fight back from physical disabilities, and my heart went out to you at one time, but life is tough, okay? And we are not going to excuse you coming out and interfering in any of our matches. I think Tully Blanchard put it best, because he's still eating inside over an I Quit incident 3 years ago where he says he never said the words. And we're not going to tolerate you coming out. Magnum, like he said, either get in rehabilitation, put a pair of tights on, or get lost. And when you came out here today shooting your mouth off, you just asked for it. You're the one that precipitated the whole thing. And all he did was tell you right to your face exactly what was going to happen. And when Dusty Rhodes came out here, Barry Windham, you came, it's just a big mess is what it is. Now, the most important thing is that Dusty Rhodes, a man that was three times NWA World Heavyweight Champion, the man that everybody calls the legend, the man that everybody loved and endeared and looked up to, took a baseball bat. That's right, a baseball bat, and struck one of the members of the World Tag Team Championship team, and then Jim Crockett Jr. on the board of directors of the National Wrestling Alliance was struck a blow at the hands of that same man, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Now, this type of actions cannot be tolerated by anyone. And it's a weekend. I can't do much right now. But Monday morning at 8 o'clock, there will be a copy of this incident on personal videotape, hand-delivered by a courier to every single member of the NWA Board of Directors. And they can watch it 100 times. One time is all I think they need to see it. And then I'm not requesting, I'm demanding that the American Dream, yes, your three times former World Heavyweight Champion, U.S. Champion, be barred from wrestling for the rest of his life. And that's the bottom line. I don't have anything further to say.
Can I say something right here? I don't take sides. I'm not condoning what Dusty Rhodes did with a baseball bat to Mr. Crockett. We're supposed to have a match in the ring. I think it warrants that we take a look at it right now. And I think what you'll find, Jim, you'll agree with me, that really Tully instigated this whole matter from the beginning.
That's beside the point, and you can show it. I would love to see it again because I think this message speaks for itself, and it's the same thing that every member of the board of directors is going to view Monday morning at 8:01 when their doorbell rings. And then, like I said, I'm demanding that the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and I'll say it right now, be barred from wrestling for the rest of his life.
Well, I'm sure they're not going to agree with that. What do you say we take a look at him?
Yeah, please.
Okay, fans.
You know, Magnum, you and I go back a long, long way. You know, I know that they're selling videos of you and I in an I Quit match, and you love it. You're getting money off of me because something that didn't happen. I've had to live for 2 years with I Quit. I Quit everywhere I go. I Quit because of you. But you know, Magnum, I felt sorry for you. Poor Magnum, like everybody else. He got hurt, poor into his career. Well, that's too bad. But you know, Magnum, when you start sticking your nose back in our business again, you stay out until you can crawl back in the ring. Then you start sticking your ring in. I don't care about equalizers. You want to bash.
It's not far enough. It's not far enough. You just want to.
Scott. Gentlemen, the Midnight Express due up here in just a few moments, but Jim Cornette will be joining us before that. What's the matter with you? Don't you feel well?
You know, Jim Ross, something happened out here today. I don't think it should pass without comment. I think most of you people know that I am, and for the past several years, have been a close personal friend of Jim Crockett Jr. And I think also, Jim Ross, you saw what happened out here. I have the greatest, utmost personal respect for Jimmy Crockett. And I think that what Dusty Rhodes did to come out here not only to take a baseball bat, a deadly weapon, try to assassinate Tully Blanchard, make a complete fiasco, wreak pandemonium and havoc through the whole television studio, but to take that very self-same, and everybody saw it, the evidence would stand up in any court in this country, take that very self-same deadly weapon to Jim Crockett, my close personal friend, and give him a serious injury. I think that whatever punishment can be meted out to Dusty Rhodes, whether it be fining, whether it be suspension, whether it be imprisonment, whether it be electrocution, any punishment that can be meted out to Dusty Rhodes is entirely deserved for what that he did right here in this studio. It would stand up in any court, the highest court in the land, what he did to my good friend, Jim Crockett Jr., my close personal friend. With a guy like Dusty Rhodes around here, I fear for my life. Except I don't fear for my life when I have these men by my side, the United States Tag Team Champions, Beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan, the Midnight Express.
It's Pink Handkerchief. He's no more, obviously. He's making a mockery out of, he likes what happened. That's the kind of guy he is.
Yeah.
He's making a mockery out of the whole,
well, whole darn thing, and I don't like that. My question is, and I go back to what we said to JJ, I'm not condoning the use of a baseball bat on anybody, but if he is so much against what Dusty Rhodes did, why in the world does he take that racket and stick it in the closet? Because it's no different.
That's one place he could stick it that would probably be appropriate. Another thing, JJ, you know, JJ wants Dusty suspended for life. JJ has had a vendetta against Dusty Rhodes for years. He's been trying to put him out of action in the ring physically, and he's not been able to do that with any of his men. So now he's going to do it through the courts. It's a lifetime suspension for the Cornette.
Well,
he's visibly shaking.
Yeah, he's... Are you got your composure now? You're gonna get yourself together.
I must be brave.
You sure you're
all
right? You gotta be a strong soldier now, right?
I've gotta be brave. You know, look at this kid to win him in the ring right now. He looks like a fishing worm wearing swimming trunks. As a matter of fact, I took a picture of Kendall Windham and hung it up behind my aquarium just to tease my fish, brother. And we are teasing Kendall Windham right there. And you see, I want to talk for just a minute about a theft, about some stealing going on. The Fantastics, those little grinning punks, have stolen, have thieved, have connived to take away the rocket launcher.
They're doing it real good, too.
They ain't
maybe
doing
better
it
than anybody I've ever seen, maybe.
I would
Jim
agree
Ross,
with that.
Let me tell you something.
I would agree with it. I would
Tony,
agree with that. Thank you.
There's been some people beat up out here today. There'd be a few more. Although we did have to put up a cash bond and we wouldn't destroy no furniture today. You see, I got a lot of audio and video equipment, gentlemen. And I get videotapes, and I got a satellite dish, and I watch every wrestling program, every wrestling match. match put on the air in this world. I'm not just talking about the NWA. I'm talking about matches from Japan, from England, Australia, New Zealand, Bulgaria, Zimbabwe, at all points west. And besides that, the championship wrestling from Bug Tussle Federation. And every time that I turn on my television, what do I see? Tag teams using the moves, using the maneuvers that the Midnight Express invented, perfected, originated, and innovated, just like that. I see all kind of tag teams from all kind of places doing the things that we've been doing for years and acting like they've done something, acting like they've come up with something. Well, that proves three things. Number one, that proves that none of those teams can think for themselves. Number two, that proves that every tag team in wrestling knows that they should follow the Midnight Express because we're the leaders, we're the innovators, we're the originators. But number three, that proves what I've been saying all along, that the Midnight Express are better than every other team in wrestling because we do more moves better than anybody does any moves. We do everything better than any other tag team does anything. And the Fantastics coming out here not only have tried to humiliate us, not only have tried to make fools out of us, not only, woo, I love to watch
my
that.
Goodness.
Not only have tried to ruin our reputation on national television, but they have tried to take our United States Tag Team titles, and tomorrow,
they
right
just
here on
might
the Superstation,
do it. That's right.
No, they just might not do it. Tomorrow on the Superstation, we're going to bring a screeching halt to all this hysteria. We are going to bring an end to the Fantastics. I promise you, I make this vow. Tomorrow on the Superstation, on the Clash of Champions, the Fantastics will not come out of that ring as United States Tag Team Champions. I promise this to you. They will not be the United States Tag Team Champions. They will learn a lesson they should have learned a long time ago, a lesson that their mommy and daddy should have taught them, a lesson that their school teacher should have taught them, a lesson that we're gonna teach them.
If you beat them fair and square, like they beat you all fair and square, I'm sure they're not gonna do as much crying about it as you have, because they did beat you guys fair and square, and I can understand your apprehension whenever they mastered the rocket launcher.
Did you hear the prediction from Paul Bosch earlier?
I heard the prediction. I've heard Paul Bosch predict things for a long time. No. Come here, Bobby.
I thought Cash Bond, you better remember that.
Get a better stereo effect. Bobby, you hit my knuckle. I'm sorry.
That's the most I've heard him talk on television in a couple of years.
Paul Bosch has been predicting the downfall of the Midnight Express for years and years and years. Every Friday night in that Sam Houston Coliseum for years, he predicted the downfall of the Midnight Express, and we emerged with the belts and our hands raised high in the air. So, Paul Bosch, you may have a Social Security number of one, but you don't know everything about wrestling. Fantastics, you may be able to do a sloppy imitation of the rocket launcher, but you have not mastered it. You have not perfected it. You can't do it like the Midnight Express can do it. And every tag team in professional wrestling is going to have to take note that what we do to the Fantastics, what we do to the Fantastics, just like we're doing to that big fat collie, we can do to anybody else.
Big bear collie to you.
Big fat collie is what his name is. That's why we're after the Fantastics. Because we got to prove by you doing anything possible to get them out of professional wrestling that no other team can come and do the same thing to us that they did, which is enter in a conspiracy to try to embarrass us. Do you realize that?
Well, I sure realize that you've been doing a lot of talking. You want to go get a drink of water?
I don't need water. I don't need food. I am existing. I am subsisting. I am literally living and breathing the thought of seeing those two little pukes, those two little munchkins, those two little goofs, those idiots, those morons, those Fantastics, the thought of seeing them in a hospital with sandbags holding their appendages up and a flea collar around their neck. And that is the rocket launcher right there. And that is what is going to spell the end of the Fantastics. They will not be the U.S. champions.
Whoa, settle down. Boy, my goodness.
He needs a warm glass of milk and a cookie. Maybe his mom will furnish that tomorrow when she's on the front row in Greensboro.
Second straight week that Jim Cornette has really gone on the edge there.
Yeah. He's teetering out there, I guarantee you that. This is a
great move, though.
Yeah,
I'll
it is.
And both teams can execute it. From the Fantastics of Midnight Express, head up tomorrow, the Clash of Champions, 4 o'clock Eastern Time. Who will win? We'll find out.
That's a real rocket launcher for you.
Big green machine, our first look at him here on Superstation TBS.
He's taking on El Negro here.
You know, we've heard a lot of things about the Big Green Machine. I understand in the NWA, and for the last couple of weeks, he has been making quite a name for himself and has become quite a force in the sport. So a good look at him against a guy, a very big competitor called El Negro, and the Big Green Machine just right up against him, pushing him right back to the corner.
Still to come, we're going to talk with Gary Hart and Al Perez. We're going to see gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Shane Douglas in tag team action. Hopefully, David Crockett's going to make it back before we run out of time here and let us know a little status report of how Jim Crockett is.
Well, one thing for sure is it was a baseball bat just flying everywhere, and unfortunately, Mr. Crockett got the blunt end of it.
It was inadvertent. You got to think it was inadvertent on Dusty Rhodes' part. What Dusty did to Tully Blanchard was obviously not inadvertent. Dusty, I think it was provoked to what he did, and I think his actions on that account were justified.
I've never seen Dusty, and you know, I've seen in all his great matches. I was there when he won the World Heavyweight title in Greensboro a couple of years ago from Ric Flair. I know he's been 3 times World Heavyweight Champion. There's a lot of times in the parking lot with the Four Horsemen breaking the hand. I've never seen Dusty wrestle. He's usually been able to handle a situation cool, calmly, and collected. But I've never seen him really react that way. But it's, you know, you said it, it's understandable to me. You know, his best friend in his whole life is Magnum T.A.
Right.
And Magnum has gone through a lot. And when Magnum was decked,
that's right,
like he was decked, it is really, to me, and I'm sure to all you fans out there, understandable.
Everybody's coming out here talking about Dusty Rhodes did this, and Dusty Rhodes should be suspended for life, and somebody should talk about Tully Blanchard. And he didn't come out here by himself. J.J. Dillon came with him.
Yeah, that's
so,
a good
you know,
point.
What business did they have coming out here anyway? And first of all, Magnum T.A. would never have gotten involved in their match if J.J. Dillon had not gotten involved first and to prevent a victory by Luger and Windham for the tag team titles.
We talk about the fire is still there with Magnum T.A. And, you know, Jim Ross, you were there with Magnum T.A.
That's right.
And the fire was still there. He saw it. Knowing his condition, he still jumped up, and he knew that this was not right. And we've known it for a long time. The NWA knows it, or it wouldn't put James J. Dillon in a cage tomorrow during the Clash of the Champions.
About 60 feet above the ring, so he won't be able to interfere in the match whatsoever. Well, and anyway, we have two big masked men here. Both of them got to be in the 300-pound range. And the Big Green Machine has been racking up some impressive victories in the last few weeks here in the National Wrestling Alliance. Yeah, I tell you, I don't know. Gosh, I just need a loss for words to think about the situation. And everybody's pointing their finger at Rhodes. And, you know, there's got to be some repercussions. Who knows what? But, you know, if J.J.'s going to lobby for a lifetime suspension, I find that'll be a little bit extreme. But
come on, back him out.
The baseball bat, it's going to warrant something.
Two.
Well, absolutely.
Two.
Right now, the Green Mean Machine, Big Mean Machine, whatever. He is pounding away at El Negro, and Negro's firing back at him. Gonna pick him up.
Big men, I'll tell you something. These are big guys going for it here on World Championship Wrestling. Still to come, a word from Gary Hart and the Latin sensation Al Perez, gorgeous Jimmy, and Shane Douglas in tag team action. Powerful elbow by the Big Green Machine.
Well, he is nailing him with it. Another one. What about one more time? Didn't need to. Boy, in a flurry, he exploded on him.
Big Green Machine with a victory here on TBS and World Championship Wrestling. The big masked man with a victory. And after a succession of elbow drops, the Big Green Machine racked up a victory here on the Superstation. And ladies and gentlemen, one of the leading managers in all of professional wrestling, and a man that witnessed this tragedy that happened in this program, is here with Tony Schiavone and I. The Big Green Machine, the winner here on TBS, and Gary Hart, you and Al Perez, I'm sure, saw what happened on the monitors.
See, a lot of people are out here talking about how surprised they are. What a violent act Dusty Rhodes perpetrated. Well, you see, I know Dusty Rhodes from day one. I had a great hand in developing his career early on. Dusty Rhodes, the side that you saw of him today is the side that he continuously tries to hide. But on more than one occasion, I have known the violence of Dusty Rhodes. On more than one occasion, in roughneck, redneck joints out in West Texas and down in South Texas, I've known Dusty Rhodes to go and get a board, a crowbar out of the back of the car, a tar iron. I've seen the man bash heads. I've seen him clean out whole bars. The one thing you must remember about one Virgil Reynolds, Dusty Rhodes, he is a violent man. It comes from his youth, and it did not surprise me at all. What did I tell you about Rhodes?
You know, Gary, a couple months back when I was after Dusty Rhodes about the U.S. title, you mentioned to me, he's a dangerous man. Don't ever turn your back on him because he'll snap. When he snaps, he'll pick up anything in sight.
Let me tell you.
You were right.
It surprised me that he has kept that side of himself hidden for so long. And I will guarantee you, if he gets an opportunity to do it again, he will. Did you notice? He went after everybody.
He was provoked.
He wants a clean house. Not only provoked. Dusty Rhodes is a violent man. Dusty Rhodes was born in violence. He was raised in violence. He is as violent and as evil as any human being that walked the face of the earth.
The sport of professional wrestling should have it controlled at all times. He should have it controlled.
Don't turn your back, brother. That's the secret. Don't turn your back.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, those comments from Gary Hart and the Latin sensation Al Perez, and we'll be back with Shane Douglas and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin in tag team action right after.
Certainly a dynamic tag team. Shane Douglas, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin with Precious against Art Prince and Mike Jackson in this next event of World Championship Wrestling. Before we go any further, we want to be able to talk to everybody tomorrow, 4 o'clock Eastern time, right here on Superstation TBS. The Clash of the Champions, Jim Ross, it's upon us.
I love it, Tony. I'm really looking forward to working with you and David Crockett, Bob Caudle, our whole crew. I know the wrestlers are going to be excited. The 5 championship matches, the big barbed wire match. You've got to think, again, what effect will what we have seen today involving Dusty Rhodes have on tomorrow's event? Across the horse, Tully Blanchard's involved in a World's Tag Team Championship match. Dusty Rhodes is involved in a 6-man war inside barbed wire.
Right.
You better be thinking about your business come bell time tomorrow, but can any of them do that? I don't know if, and you and I are going to be there doing the play-by-play. It's going to be hard to maintain that train of thought until we find out something, hopefully from David Crockett or somebody, about the status of Jim Crockett and others.
My feeling is, and I don't know the status on Dusty Rhodes right now, where he is, or he's somewhere, obviously, thinking over what happened. I would think he is every bit as mad right now as he was when he first came out here. And he needs to really, tomorrow, somebody can really get hurt in a barbed wire match.
Yeah, yes, sir.
I mean, seriously, for life type hurt. And Dusty Rhodes needs to be thinking about his match tomorrow, but the man is going to be in another irate mood.
Well, you're right.
Dusty Rhodes has never been like this, ever.
Well, we'll address that tomorrow as it happens. There's David Fry, Miami Dolphin linebacker. The Dolphins have invaded
TBS.
TBS here.
Big wrestling fans of the NWA, and as we know, Miami, the Knight Center, the NWA returning there in April with another big card, and coming back down into Florida to Jacksonville, the O'Connell Center in Gainesville. So the NWA is returning to the Sunshine State. I know the Dolphins love the NWA and all the fans down there also.
Jimmy Garvin from Tampa, Florida, to continue that tie, and there's young Shane Douglas. A fine example of a young man that has got some college hours behind him. He's raised in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, in there with the veteran Mike Jackson. Shane Douglas is going to be teaming with Ricky Santana in the Crockett Cup. Of course, Jimmy Garvin involved with a matchup that is so bizarre and so weird, so strange, the Prince of Darkness death match.
That's got to be...
And Jim Garvin signed it. That's what scares me. Garvin signed it without even knowing the stipulations or what it was. He wants Kevin Sullivan that badly in the ring. And Sullivan's laughing about it. I've got him in my match. This is my match.
He really does. right up with the arm of Mike Jackson. The NWA going coast to coast. Hello to all of our friends wherever you may be. The NWA returning to Cincinnati back in April. Also, the NWA in April going, as we said, to Florida. The Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup will be coming to Greenville, South Carolina, and Greensboro, Jim.
You bet. Carolina Connection coming.
Yeah, back at the Tingley Coliseum in Albuquerque one more time. Las Cruces, the Pan American Center.
Jimmy Garvin dropping the leg on Mike Jackson. Garvin with that very physical and dangerous death match with Kevin Sullivan. That match, ladies and gentlemen, signed only for Greenville, South Carolina, Friday night, April the 22nd. And that's the only night that you can see all 24 of the finest tag teams in wrestling compete in one night. That's in Greenville on the 22nd of April. Nice tag. Shane Douglas comes in.
We're the top 10 seeds in that tournament. You will find out tomorrow live on the Clash of the Champions Superstation TBS and the NWA combining for what certainly is going to be an afternoon extended into evening wrestling that you'll never forget.
Shane Douglas in a little predicament there, but quickly gets out of Big Bear College, a 300-pounder, and a nice snap suplex by Shane Douglas. You know one thing about the belly-to-belly suplex? Art Prince, I'm sorry. Bear College was in the last match. I'm still thinking about the Rhodes incident.
Well,
Jim Crockett situation. I apologize to that, fans.
It jogs everybody's mind. It really does, and it's on our mind. And not only that, it will be for very many weeks and months to come.
You know, I've seen a lot of strange and just surprising things in my career. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that. I know I haven't. Made a double impression on me, I'll tell you that for sure. Young Shane Douglas up on the second rope. Nice move by this youngster. Ladies, there's a bright spot in today's program, I'll tell you. Shane and gorgeous Jimmy looking great here in this tag team matchup.
We do want to let you know once again, fans, as Jim Ross reported earlier, Magnum TA is fine. He was decked by Tully Blanchard. Although the situation, the condition of Mr. Jim Crockett is still unknown at this time, and we are near the end of our two-hour program. We do hope to have David out here a little bit later, a couple of minutes from now, hopefully. And that brain buster certainly should put his lights out, and it has.
Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and Shane Douglas with a victory here on the Superstation. And Art Fritz feels what it's like to have the brain buster from gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Gorgeous one, beautiful, precious, and Shane Douglas, a great victory for that duo. I'll tell you something, Tony, it has been quite a day.
Yeah, it really has. It's certainly a day that we did not expect. Mr. Paul Boscher's here that we're appreciative of.
Here's David.
David, I know. Come on in here and talk to us, and we're all our thoughts with you and the family this time. How's Jimmy doing?
He took a pretty good blow.
Yeah.
He really did, but we're taking care of him. And the way my brother is, he'll bounce back. I know he will.
I'm sure he will. And you've been with him since this time, and let him know that we're all thinking about him.
All right.
And hopefully we can get back and talk to him very soon.
Tony, like JJ said, we cannot tolerate what went on. We cannot tolerate it at all. Tully Blanchard, we can't tolerate what you did. Remember that. Okay. Isn't that correct?
I would agree with you.
All right. You fans be the judge right now. You go back and you watch it and you decide whether it's Tully Blanchard or Dusty Rhodes who needs to be suspended. You watch it. Just go
take
ahead.
A look at it.
Start sticking your ring in. I don't care about equalizers. You want it back.
Just far enough. Just go far enough. You just watch it.
Oh my God.